the Hawaiians in Hawaii history, the Amus would name the first child, nicknames. And give them nicknames after him. So I was named Buttons because I was small and my hair was like little buttons. And then like my brother, his name Noble. His nickname is Buddy. Basically, I grew up in Waikiki, and right near the wall, right near Waikiki Wall. I lived in, on a street called Wainani Way, and it's about a block away to the beach, right near the Waikiki Wall, and parallel with the zoo. So I was basically raised in Waikiki. I think my mom moved to Waikiki when I was six. I think I was like 65 or something. But originally my family's from the North Shore. Mm-hmm. My grandpas and uncles, they were all Paniolas, probably from the North Shore. My first surfboard, my mom actually bought me my first surfboard. But I had to grunt and fight and kick and cry and scream, but she finally broke down and bought me one potato chip and shape that is. With hips.
Okay.
Potato chip. Yeah. And it all started for me right there at the wall, Waikiki Wall. Mm-hmm. I lived only a block away to the beach. My family life growing up was just me, my brother Ricky, and my mom. I never was really raised by my dad, so my mom was my dad. Mm-hmm. So if I try to run away, you know, act stupid, she'd catch me in the 50-yard dash and just kick the shit.
Gotta do that early, huh?
You said right, she had to teach me early or else. You know what? I love my mom, you know? Well, back then, I was like 7 or 8 years old. I used to see my Uncle Buddy, who just got out of the Vietnam War. He used to leave his board at our house. And every time he come to our house, then he had super long hair after the Vietnam War. I'd follow him down to the wall, like 5-10 feet from behind, watch him. I was mesmerized by his surfboards. And we were so close to the beach, yeah? I remember my mom telling me, boy, don't go to the beach. Unless we all, you know, as a family go, yeah, okay, mom. When your mom tell you no, that means it must mean yeah. It must mean yes, go, you know. So I used to follow my uncle down to the beach, the water line, and watch him surf at the wall and this place called Ins and Outs, where the wave hit the breakwater as you're going in and then backwash and to go back out. So pretty much, you know, right there in Waikiki, just pretty much he was the one that got me to like, wow, I'm gonna try this. This is like fun, you know? So I watched him for like 4 or 5 times when he would come. Yeah, I remember my mom always telling me, make sure you don't go to the beach. And someday she come home, you went to the beach? I would go, no, mom. Whack! You went to the beach? No, mom. Whack! Oh, mom, what's that for? How can you lie to mom? Stop lying to mom. I would be all sunburned. I would be toasted. Paele, papa.
Yeah.
So after that, no more lying. Yeah, mom, I went to the beach. And you know, so I basically taught myself how to swim, how to paddle. I used to get rubbish, half of a foam board that the tourists would throw away, and go on the side of the wall and push myself and ride them all the way to the beach. Before you know it, I was standing up on the foam boards and riding them to the beach, running up the wall, jumping off the wall, riding them to the beach. Till some Hawaiian guy see me, he said, hey, Buttons. He made me one wooden board, like a piper board with fins. And that was it.
Bit already.
Yes. I was like, oh, boy. What next? Were you good waves, bro? You guys been before?
No. One day.
Yeah, bro. Gotta go. It's beautiful. You go, Papayete. You're in your car with your balls. 45 minutes, you're in Moria. You're on the right point. I swear to God. You take off. You turn. You pull his barrel. You come out. You make a run off. You go back down. Turn again. Barrel. Cut back. Come back down. Oh, one more. Wow. Cut back. Oh, maybe I hit it. Oh, wait, one more section. Four barrels already. And then you go ahead and cut back, run house, you just true traveling. Then that inside pit, maybe the thing about this big, but, and that one kind of went, I was riding on 6'4". 6'4" ball, you need big balls out of that. The second, third dip, but maybe five times long. You know how third dip is, eh? But five times long, bro, it's freaking perfect, dude. Then on the other side of the island, it's called Haupitia. In Maria, Haupitia, telling them about the surf they never been to. They would love it, bro. It's like Hawaii, 100 years ago. In all occasions, like us Hawaiians, we know Milan, yeah? Over there, everybody in that. All occasions, yeah, man. It's unbelievable. Growing up as a little kid, you know, I lived a couple blocks away from Reno and Ramia Valera. And I see BK a lot too, so Larry Bergman, Ben Ipa, Josh Sutherland, Jerry Lopez, Reno Valera. Those guys are a big part of influence of my influence of being, you know, being a grom. And just sit on the beach and just watch these guys just rip it up, man. Just tearing it up, bro. They used to have, like, people have collages of us, me, or, you know, us local boys. They used to have collages of them guys, the older guys. You know?
Buzzy Kerr.
Buzzy Kerr Box, bro. Dane Kealoha.
Yeah.
Yeah. We all same era, yeah?
Yeah.
And, yeah, so... If it wasn't for the ocean, I probably would have been dead, or I'd probably be in jail, you know?
Yeah.
So I have to give thanks to our God. I give thanks to God, you know, my mom, and my friends. They really care about me. Also, good kid. Great kid. He's ripping. You know? Get Kalaho. Get Kaiho. Saw the whole family, yeah, that Derek and the nephews. That's actually Willie Grace's, my friend, good friend, Willie Grace from Waikiki. They're two sons. And they work for me too, yeah? And they're good surfers. You know, there's a lot of kids out there that, up and coming kids, you know? And a lot of them are fortunate, you know, gotta go to school and homeschool. The whole school thing, I don't really, it's kind of cheating, you know what I mean? My day's no homeschool, bro. Get your ass to school, you know what I mean? Some homework. I used to have on balcony, high as this, boom, the rope, boom. My mom's door is right there. Train the rope, 5 in the morning. My cereal downstairs, everything. Little cup of ice. Get back home, leave the ball downstairs, right to school. I went to Jefferson Elementary, yeah? Mm-hmm. So, yeah, so it's kind of growing up was pretty gnarly.
Any tips you want to give the Groms or any shout outs?
Yeah, I mean, I like to say to all the up and coming kids, you know, like Zikio, you know, the Moniz, all the Moniz kids. I mean, the list goes on, and, you know, Kalani Chapman. I mean, enjoy the ride, you know? Don't let it get to your head. Take it one step at a time. And really, in reality, if you want it, and you're really willing to go get it, the sky's the limit, man. Charge it. Charge them, be safe, obey the laws. I've done a lot of partying in my time. Like I said, I should have been dead or institutionalized. But God said no. And honestly, I can tell you guys today, I just had found out that I was diagnosed with cancer. I'm at the stage 4 right now. So, you know, I get these beautiful kids. Mm-hmm. And sometimes they ask, why me, you know? It wasn't my choice. It's of course. You know, God says it's your time, it's your time. So I have to be strong. I've heard of people curing themselves, eating the right things. You know, life is short. You put bad stuff in your body, bad stuff can stay in your body. And later on in life, you will have to live with it. You know, as for me, it's hereditary too. My grandpa, my grandma, my auntie, my mom. It still really hadn't hit me, but it has. You know, I feel it, not only me feel it, everyone around me, everyone who's known me, you know, feels sad. I think we get plenty more life left to give up. Keep my spirits up. Pray to a core. Pray to God. I'm a strong boy, a strong man. Because I don't know what's coming tomorrow. I live for today. I'm happy when I'm walking. There's a wrong way and there's a right way. It's hard for me to say no. I don't know if it's pure pressure or just me. Why don't we try this? I want to try that. This is good. This is great. I like it. But for today's youth, what I can recommend, what I can say, because I've truly been in it, you know? Thank God I never did no time. Thank God I didn't kill nobody. The only person I was going to kill was going to be myself. And it just may happen. But stay close to the ones that love you the best, and that would be family, you know? The ones who love you as your family and your really, really close friends.
Can now he love it, Papa Lohima?